Jason and the DIY Network. I'm Christine.
And I'm Danny.
And this is America's most desperate landscape. Danny and I met while studying architecture at the University of Kansas, and we moved to Denver 3 years ago. We bought this house in May of 2016, and with the housing market in Denver, we were happy just to be able to afford something with a roof.
We love Denver. With the proximity to the mountains, it's exactly what fits our lifestyle. However, most people don't know that Denver is actually in a desert climate. Let me go show you what that means.
Outdoor kitchen. I got this propane grill, free from my boss, and we got this charcoal grill as a hand-me-down from Danny's parents.
Rat!
That's not a rat, that's our dog, Nora.
And this is our sandbag. It keeps the water out of our house when it rains. Our patio slopes toward the house, so when it does rain, it floods our laundry room.
Yeah. This is what we have right now for a patio or dining area. We'd love it to be bigger. Right now we can only fit four. And we typically have, I don't know, parties from 10 to 20 people that we'd like to feed. It'd be nice if it was bigger and ideally did not slope back to the house.
That'd be great.
We've tried to dress it up a little bit with these LED lights, but it'd be really nice if it wasn't just the lights that looked nice and the whole backyard did.
Over here's one of the features of our yard. It's our Zinger. It rocks.
Aren't you just feeling calm by looking at it?
Then you can come over here. As you can tell, our ground is incredibly uneven. It'd be fantastic if it was flat and we could walk on it without worrying about tripping.
Not to mention if we were actually able to grow something. Living in a desert climate has its perks. There's no mosquitoes, so we can use this space at least 9 months of the year. But it'd be nice if we could do something that were native species or plants that didn't require as much water. Speaking of sustainable practices though, we did install this rainwater barrel this year, and that, I mean, when it has water in it, we use it to water our garden, but it's nice to have.
Over here's the play area.
When we bought this house, this was a sandbox. As you can tell, it's extremely overgrown, and this whole side yard is kind of funny. We don't really know what to do with it.
And another feature of the yard is over here. This is our oak tree, Mick.
So this is a bur oak tree, and it's a little scrawny because we used to have a Chinese sumacs, or tree of heaven, along the back. And when we cut them down, they send up all these shoots, and I come out here once a week to just pull.
They're everywhere.
Yeah, I mean, it's hard for me to be out here and not pull this. This is 1 week of growth, and so we'd really like to be able to have an actual landscaped yard. These are planter boxes, and
we built them ourselves.
Yeah, we built them ourselves. The peppers are doing really well this year, so we're excited about that, but we'd like to have more of a raised bed situation. The peppers are hot.
Really spicy.
Yeah.
So hot.
So as we mentioned earlier, we met in architecture school, and we like to think that we can do a lot of the work ourselves, but we also know when it's out of our league. So Jason, we'd really appreciate it if you could help us make it America's greatest backyard instead of the most desperate backyard.
My mouth is on fire. Oh!